Game Boost is a unique feature for MSI and has been on motherboards for quite a while. And it offers a simple way to get extra performance with 1 second of work.
Simply put, as per MSI, Game Boost enables 1 second overclocking, boosting performance so you can achieve more frames per second.
The history of MSI Game Boost can be traced back all the way to mid-2007 when Intel launched their P35 Express chipset for LGA 775 processors. The feature wasn't called Game Boost back then, but the function was very similar, a one-step process to achieve better system performance.
Browsing through the manual of the MSI P35 Neo2-FR motherboard, we find on page 2-19 a feature called Hardware Overclock FSB Jumpers. By configuring these jumpers in different positions, you can change the front side bus frequency between 200, 266, and 333 MHz. This in turn increases the CPU core frequency. About 1 year later, around June 2008, Intel launched the P45 Express chipset, also for the LGA 775 processors. MSI retained the OC jumper as a way to increase the front side bus frequency from 266 MHz to 400 MHz, though it was rebranded as Rapid Boost.
It wasn't until the launch of the Intel X58 chipset for LGA 1366 processors that MSI switched from the old-fashioned jumpers to the more user-friendly switches.
The easy OC switch, implemented on motherboards like the X58 Eclipse SLI, was still the one-step overclocking tool that allows users from any pedigree to increase the performance of their system by overclocking. Undoubtedly well-intended by MSI, but perhaps a thorn in the eye of Intel, MSI's marketing slides point out that the easy OC switch can turn your $300 Core i7-920 into a $1,000 Core i7-965. Not all reviewers agreed with MSI. Steve Walton from TechSpot, nowadays at Hardware Unboxed, found the feature to be, quote, rather pointless.
Regardless, MSI continued its mission to provide novice users with an easy way to overclock the CPU and improve system performance. In September 2009, Intel launched the P55 chipset for LGA 1156 processors, and MSI came with something totally new, OC Genie.
MSI OC Genie is a hardware-based automatic overclocking tool that relies on an actual chip on the motherboard to overclock the CPU. In a press release, MSI said that they used their 20-year R&D experience to develop the new Easy OC technology, OC Genie. Combining OC Genie's press button and dedicated overclocking processor, no complicated setup and professional overclocking skills are required to boost up to 45% performance in 1 second. By just the press of the OC Genie button, the OC Genie processor automatically detects the best overclocking settings of CPU, memory, and integrated graphics. Furthermore, OC Genie also adjusts the voltage settings to ensure stability. Reading through motherboard reviews from the time, OC Genie seems to have been very well received. Guru3D extensively tested OC Genie with the MSI P55 GD80 motherboard, and by the press of a button, managed to increase the Core i7-870 CPU frequency by 800 MHz from 2.93 GHz to 3.74 GHz. They also indicate this was a 100% stable overclock. MSI OC Genie eventually also carried over to some X58 motherboards like the MSI Big Bang X58 X-Power, as well as in BIOS form appeared as OC Genie Lite on certain AMD motherboards. It got a little bit confusing at the time, as some AMD motherboards like the MSI 890GXM-G65 featured both OC Genie Lite in the BIOS and an easy OC switch on the motherboard itself. Oh yeah, that's a forum post by the same top PC who now works for MSI.
Moving forward, when Intel launched the P67 chipset for LGA 1155 Sandy Bridge processors in 2011, MSI introduced OC Genie 2.
The second generation of OC Genie was pretty similar to the first generation, but better, As MSI claims, now even your girlfriend can get extra performance. Not entirely sure that line of thought would be possible these days. Sandy Bridge fundamentally changed the way overclocking is done. Whereas before Sandy Bridge, CPUs could be overclocked by increasing the base clock frequency, on Sandy Bridge, overclocking was restricted exclusively to the KSQ CPUs with unlocked CPU multipliers. Undeterred by this limitation, MSI claimed OC Genie 2 would increase the clock frequency of a Core i5-2500K by 900 MHz from 3.3 GHz to 4.2 GHz. Many reviewers had a go at overclocking with OC Genie 2, including a young Linus Tech Tips. With the press of a single button, young Linus managed to overclock his Core i7-2600K to 4.2 GHz.
In April 2012, Intel launched the successor to Sandy Bridge, Ivy Bridge, with its Z77 chipset.
MSI's leading mainstream overclocking board was the Empower, which also featured OC Genie 2. Young Linus again showed off the overclocking capabilities of the OCG2 feature, demonstrating a
30%+ improvement.
The OC Genie 2 feature was also present on a wide range of MSI X79 motherboards, allowing media such as PC Perspective to achieve an overclock of 400 MHz on a Core i7-3820 with a base frequency of 3.6 GHz.
Then came Haswell and its Z87 chipset in 2013. Here's where MSI took the automatic overclocking tool in a fresh direction. There are several changes to how OC Genie works.
First, we jump straight from OC Genie 2 to OC Genie 4. Second, the function is now available both in the form of the traditional button as well as a virtual OC Genie in the BIOS. Third, an OC Genie mode switch provides two gears which determine how aggressive OC Genie pursues the overclock. Based on Anantec's coverage of the MSI Z87 X-Power motherboard, Gear 1 would overclock the Core i7-4770K to 4 GHz, whereas Gear 2 would overclock that same CPU to 4.2 GHz. The Haswell refresh and accompanying Z97 chipset wasn't much of a change from the products launched 1 year earlier. MSI pretty much adopted the same OC Genie 4 feature set. Also, on the HEDT X99 platform, the implementation was the same, at least on the first generation launched in 2014 together with the Haswell E processors.
Then in August 2015, something changed. When Intel launched the 6th generation Core processor codenamed Skylake and its Z170 chipset, MSI put the OC Genie back in its bottle and introduced the Game Boost knob.
Game Boost's function is not too different from OC Genie in that it still aims to provide an easy way for novice users to overclock their CPU. When researching the Game Boost knob, I came across an interesting story on the origins of this physical knob. The long story short is that Anantec's Ian Catress claims he's responsible for MSI's decision to bring this knob to market. As his story goes, the knob originally featured on development versions of MSI's Z170 motherboards and was used by the engineers to do specific things like loading OC profiles, safe booting, memory safe booting, applying specific settings, and so on. Ian alleges he convinced MSI to repurpose this knob or dial as a multi-step overclocking function. The Z170 Game Boost knob is an 8-step dial that goes from 0 to 11. Each step has a predefined base clock frequency, CPU ratio, and voltage, which lifts the frequency of a Core i7-6700K from 4300 MHz at step 1 to 5000 MHz at step 11. The virtual BIOS version of Game Boost offered no multi-step approach, but a binary on-off for the Core i7-6700K. Game Boost on means running at 4.4 GHz, which is equal to Game Boost Step 2 on boards with the 8-step dial. MSI adopted the Game Boost knob on the 2nd generation X99 motherboards, which launched with the Broadwell E processors. We even have a video up on this channel where we overclock a Broadwell E Core i7-6950X processor using the MSI Game Boost dial on the MSI X99A Gaming Pro Carbon motherboard. By now, The virtual Game Boost knob in the BIOS offered the same features as the physical dial on the motherboard, with 8-step multi-level overclocking from 0 to 11.
And here's where the Game Boost knob sort of continues to live on. The high-end motherboards have this 8-step dial up to 11, as well as a virtual version of this multi-step overclocking tool, and the mid-end to low-end motherboards just have the on-off button in the BIOS.
On the Z270 motherboards, you'll find automatic Game Boost overclocking for the 6th gen and 7th gen processors. On X299 motherboards, which still feature the Game Boost dial, it no longer bears the intrusive bright red color, but is replaced by a black dial. The 8-step overclocking up to 11 persists. On the Z390 motherboards, the button still goes up to 11 and changes the CPU ratio as well as CPU voltage. By this time, AMD had risen from the bulldozer ashes and also gets their Game Boost function. On the X370X Power Gaming Titanium, we find the same bright red button as on the high-end Intel motherboards, and we find the same 8-step overclocking levels up to 11. We find the less intrusive black dial version on the MSI X470 Gaming M7 AC, with more overclocking up to 11. We also find the black dial on the X570 Godlike, launched in the summer of 2019.
In 2020, the MSI Game Boost knob disappeared from the high-end MSI motherboards, and we get the same Game Boost implementation across the entire product stack. That is, a single BIOS button that either enables or disables the Game Boost function. The function is also the same across the product stack. That is, you get one turbo ratio extra over default when you enable Game Boost. And that's where we find ourselves right now.
Enabling Game Boost on the Z690 Carbon EK X lifts all turbo ratios by +1 for both P cores and E cores. In addition, it also sets an AVX negative ratio offset of -3.